Hello children, good morning. How are you all? So today we are going to see a new topic. Our next lesson, next to Abdullah lesson, the supplementary reading we are going to see obey your parents. Why is it important to obey your parents? Can anyone tell? Why is it important to obey your parents? See, parents want to give advice all the time because they want to protect you from making the mistakes. So they made or that someone they know. Okay, so maybe that before doing the mistake they may protect you. So obedience to parents is important. Okay. If we listen to our parents and do what they say, then they will not nag us so much. See, always parents will not say no to everything what you all telling always whenever you ask anything. Okay, children. So think why they are telling no. Okay. So there will be a message in that. Okay, children. So first of all, you should obey your parents. So how do you obey your parents? So you should listen to them. Whatever they are talking, you should listen to them. You should show respect to them. You should not immediately give back answer to them. Okay, always don't disagree with them. Always say, okay, mommy, okay, daddy. I will do this little later because I am doing homework. I will do it later. If daddy is asking you to give some water, amma, please give some water. When daddy is coming after from our office, when he is sitting, when he comes, immediately what you should do, kids, you should go run and bring the water to daddy. Okay, you should bring the water and give help him to take his bag, whatever it is, laptop, whatever, lunch bag. Or like that, go run and get that and keep it in that place. So your parents will be very happy to that. Okay. So even what God is telling, God also telling to obey your parents. Yes or no? So he is telling that children should obey the father and mother, and also they should honor them. You should give that respect. Okay, if everything should go well in your life, then you should obey your parents. Is that okay, children? See, always obey your parents. That's what a good habit, that is what you needed in now. If you have that obeying your parents, that seed inside within you, know, later it will be useful for you. When you become big, then you will show the same respect, love. See, they are showing, no? They are showing the same love throughout your life. Okay? So, like that, in turn, you also should obey them. So, on seeing this, I am going to tell you a small story. What is this? Can anyone tell me what is this? What is this? Yes, this is a small deer, baby deer. Okay, baby deer means, see, it is called as fawn. Okay, so before that, I would like to give you some information regarding this. I'll tell you the story first and then I will start to read, okay, the book part. So the young deer, okay, the young one, that light brown color, no, the small one, it is called as fawn. See, fawn, fawn. Okay, that small young ones means like 6 months before, like small baby, no, that is called as fawn, fawn. Okay, so what happened, this fawn, one day always this fawn will be with the mother. Yes or no, even the small baby, even till 1 year, the baby is with the mother only. Yes or no, the baby will not walk, it cannot walk. After 10 months, it may try sometimes, okay? So, till then, who is taking care? The mother is taking care of the baby thoroughly, okay? So, like that, once upon a time, what happened? There lived a little fawn with his mother. So, always, you know, this little deer, the young one, you know, always, wherever the mother is going, this baby is going, the mother also used to follow that fawn, because it is very small. No, see, it is in the forest, wild animals are more around that fawn, so mother is very protective. So wherever this little baby was going, mother was also following that. Same like you also. See, till 4 years you are not going to school, but wherever you mommy is going, she is taking you, she is carrying you. Yes or no? Even to the shop, next shop also, you are following your mother. The small ones, have you seen that? Even your siblings, a small one, younger ones, what they'll do? They always follow the mother, and the mother also will be at the back of the child only. Okay, like that, this baby fawn also was roaming here and there. Wherever it is going, the mother was following that. But what happened? This little fawn, you know, this little baby deer, no, doesn't like that, because it wanted to explore things. So that deer is thinking that it has grown up, so he wanted to go alone and do everything, but it could not know. Yes or no, 1 year baby, 2 year baby, can it come to school? No, like that. So like this small one, as soon as it grown up, it thought that it is grown a big, like adult, okay? It's grown up like that. So this one day, what happened, this when the mother was sleeping, slowly what happened, this little deer, it came outside, okay? It came without knowing. It ran away without knowing. Mother was sleeping. That time, without telling to her, this small baby deer ran away. See, here it was a hot summer day. See, it was hot summer day that the deer could not play alone there. It was playing, but still, who will be playing there in the hot sun? It is very hot also. So soon after, it started to thirst. It felt thirst. But this little baby was enjoying, because it is alone playing, running here and there. On seeing this open place, no, in this forest, in this field, it was playing like anything. It was very thrilling for that little young one. But soon after, it wanted to drink some water. So what happened? It went into nearby a stream to drink water. Okay, so soon after this baby deer was drinking, it suddenly saw a lion there. A lion staring at him, looking at him. Okay, it could, this fawn, no, cannot stand there. It started to tremble, got it shivering. Oh my god, what happens? No, it is a wild animal. Immediately the lion will kill the little one. Yes or no? The lion is a wild animal, so this is a prey for that lion. So what happened? Slowly it was licking and drinking. But what happened? No, this lion called him and said, "See, you spoiled my water. Why? Because you are drinking and I am next to you. I am drinking. So you have made the water dirty." Like that, it was slowly speaking. Have you seen how the lion roar? Have you heard that noise? How like that, huh? I don't know, my voice has gone up or something. Like that, it will make that noise, you know. See, with that roaring sound, what happened? And this is asking, because of you only, this water became dirty. Like that, it was telling. Then this fawn started moving slowly backward and told, "Sir, sir, how can I spoil the water, sir? See, it is flowing from your side to my side. So how will I spoil it?" Like that, slowly it started to speak. Then immediately this lion, no, it is only you. Like that, suddenly what happened? It ran, it went backside and started to run. When it was running, mother was calling the fawn. Soon the mother came near that little baby, and within a fraction of second they disappeared. Within a fraction of second, it ran very fast and it went home. See children, that's what ma'am is telling. See, whatever your parents is telling. See, look at this fawn, whether that fawn obey. See, it didn't obey the mother. It wanted to roam alone. What happened? Suddenly the lion came. If at all, if the mother is not there, what will happen? What will happen, my dears? See, something will happen. Something, because the wild animal may kill the lion. That's why we have to obey our parents. That's what this mother also, always with the fawn, little fawn. Yes or no? See, we should obey our parents. That is for good only. Okay, that is for good reason. Sometimes you may feel that is like what to tell. You will feel like disappointed. But still, you should not think that always they are bullying me. Not like that, or always disappointing. Okay. See, whatever it is, wherever you are. Okay. So, you should always, you should focus only on family alone. See, we all... Now, no, we all are seeing so many movies, so many, what to tell, other state people also are coming to Bangalore, and we also moving here and there to other places, to abroad, Western countries. See, that culture is different, but our culture is different. We have to focus only on the family. We have daddy, mummy, ajji, tata, and our siblings. Only like this. So always what your focus should be, whatever your friends or somebody else are telling, what you should do? No, that is not good for me. So we have to obey our parents. Whatever they are telling, you should be like, you should agree with that. You should go with the parents. Okay, so like what I'm trying to tell is, so that is only right. That is only like what to tell. Don't think that it is a law or like that. See, that is only correct. That is only good. If you have a good heart, means then you should obey your parents. If you want to be a good person, then you have to obey. Okay, because parents are gift from God. God only created our parents. To that parents, God only gave you. So you should obey your parents. Okay. So you should follow whatever they are telling. If they are telling you to do some small works, you should obey them. Okay. You have to do that. Okay, if you are not willing to do, tell it politely, "Daddy, I can't do it. Mommy, I can't do it." Say the reason. Is that okay, children? Is that okay? So you should, obey your parents and honor them. If you are not obeying, then what is the use to live on the earth? Is it not correct? You should, if you are living on the earth as a human being, you should obey your parents. Okay, that is the right thing, children. Even you should teach that to your younger ones also, to the siblings also. Okay, when your parents become very old, what you should do? You should take care of them very nicely. How your parents are doing now, like that, you should help them. If the mommy cannot able to drink, you feed her. Okay, mommy, daddy, you should take care nicely. Okay, children. Okay, shall we move on to the lesson? Shall we move on to the lesson? Take page number 102. Take page number 102. So, shall I read the lesson? Can you see it? Okay. There lived a little fawn with his mother. The fawn thought that he always had to go everywhere with his mother. Now he was grown up. He could go alone to places, but his mother did not allow him. The fawn found it very frustrating and decided to sneak off alone without informing anyone. On a hot summer day, when the fawn's mother was asleep, he slipped out from there. He went to an open field and began to play earth hither and thither and found it very thrilling. After some time, he felt thirsty. He went to a nearby stream to drink water. After he had finished drinking water, he saw a lion staring at him from the upper side of the stream. The lion was licking his lips and planning to eat him. The fawn was aghast to see a lion with red and burning eyes, lolling his tongue with a clear intention to devour him. He began trembling with fear. He did not know what to do. The lion called him and said, "You have spoiled the water. You know I'm drinking the water that has been made dirty by you." The fawn started moving backward slowly and said, "Sir, how can I spoil the water? It is flowing from your side towards me." The lion did not know what new blame to put on him again. Suddenly, he heard a deer calling the fawn. The fawn ran quickly to the mother within a few seconds. They were out of sight. The lion was disappointed. It is correctly said that children should obey their parents in order to getting into difficulties. Is that clear, children? Okay. Shall we move on to the fill in the blanks? This meanings? Fawn, young one of a deer. Frustrating, causing anger. Sneak off, to leave a place quietly without being seen or heard. Hither and thither, here and there in a disorderly manner. Thrilling, causing great pleasure and excitement. Aghast, frightened, terrified. Lolling, hanging out from the mouth. Intention, goal or purpose. Devour, to eat quickly, greedily or hungrily. Okay, come on to the question answer. Why did the fawn feel frustrated? Why it was frustrated? Because the lion was staring at him from the upper side of the stream. So that's why it got frustrated. Okay. What did the fawn do when its mother was asleep? When the mother was asleep, the fawn found... Why did the fawn feel frustrated? First, that question is different. Okay, sorry. See, the first question is from page number 102. The first fourth line. Okay. So, he was grown up. He could not go alone to places. But his mother did not allow him. So, the fawn found it very frustrating. So that is the first answer. Okay, sorry dear. What did the fawn do when its mother was asleep? When the mother was asleep, what happened? The fawn sneak off alone without informing the mother. What answer did the fawn give to the lion? Sir, how can I spoil the water? It is flowing from your side towards me. Okay. So that's all, children. From this lesson, what do you learn? Obey your parents. It is a must. Okay. Then only our life will be fruitful and blessed one. Thank you, children.